Hello, good morning students, welcome back. Today we can discuss one of the important topic, that is integers, the addition of integers. Students, in the previous classes also you can some of the topics about integers we can discuss. Today we can discuss adding of integers. So in this adding of integers, we can face some of the cases like integers numbers can have a positive or a negative sign, and the signs matters. Let's learn how to consider these cases. Then can be different possible conditions, like first case is both the numbers may be positive, both the numbers may be negative, one number may be positive and another may be negative, and one number may be positive or negative and the other may be zero. Let's look each case one by one. So first case, both numbers are positive. When the both numbers are positive, just we can do regular addition. We know add 12 plus 20, we can add 12 plus 20. So we know how to add when two numbers are same sign, that means it is 32 plus 32. So we have to remember that both numbers are positive, then sum will always be a positive. So we can do just regular addition. See another one example, plus 56 plus 27. So answer is plus 83. So another one, plus 125 plus 101. So we know that when two numbers are positive sign, then the sum, that means the answer always be a positive number. In the second case, both numbers are negative. So ignore the sign, add the numbers and give the sum of a negative sign. For example, minus 46, minus 25. You take on minus as a common, you write down minus of 46 plus 25. Are you understanding this? So you can write 46 plus 25 is 71 and minus sign. If both numbers are negative, their sum will always be a negative. In another one example, minus 12 and minus 89, minus 12 plus of minus 89, take minus as a common, so you can write 12 plus 89, so answer will be minus 101. So you have to remember the statement, if both numbers are positive, then answer will be positive. Both numbers are negative, the answer will be negative. So see, 124 plus 150, the answer is minus 274. This is the second case. So we can discuss the third case. One number is positive and the other is negative. What will we do? Subtract the smaller number from larger one and give the sign of the larger one. Subtract smaller from larger number and give the larger number sign in the answer. For example, minus 50 and plus 34. You write minus 50 plus 34. So what you have to do? You do the subtraction. You do the subtraction. Minus 50 plus 34 is, it is 16, and give a negative sign because the larger number is 50. It have negative sign. So in the answer you can write negative. For example, 112 and minus 95. So in this case the larger number is 112. Its sign will be positive. Then the answer will become in a positive. 112 minus 95. You can subtract 112 minus 95. It happen, okay, 112 plus of minus 95, it happen, the answer is plus 17 because the larger number have positive sign. See another one example, minus 134 plus 225. So in case also where the larger number is 275, it have plus sign, so the answer will become in the positive sign. So minus 134 plus 275, it happened minus sorry, plus 141. Are you understand? If the two numbers are different, then you can subtract and give the answer to which number have larger sign, you can write that. For example, minus 222 plus 163, the bigger number is 222, then answer will become in the minus. Subtract 222 plus 163 minus, it is minus 59. It is minus 59. Is it right? Because the larger number is 222. So in the case 4, one number is positive or negative and another is 0. So when you are adding or subtracting with the 0, the answer is the number itself only. For example, minus 49 and 0, you can write minus 49 only be answer. If you are adding and subtracting with the 0, the number itself be a answer and sign, the number sign itself be a sign of the answer. So let's we revise what we have discussed. In addition of integers, it have we face four cases, both numbers are positive, then you just do regular addition, both numbers are negative, ignore the sign and add, give the sum and answer will be in negative. In case 3, one number is positive and another one is negative, subtract the smaller number from the larger one and give the sign of the larger one. In case 4, one number is positive or negative and the other is 0, we add or subtract 0, the answer is number itself only. Students, have you understand? I hope you can understand this addition of integers. It's a very easy to understand that. Okay, let's I stop here. In next class we can discuss some other topic. Thank you.